Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and I am back with another video, how to create a team in GitHub. In our previous video, we have seen how to create organization and project in GitHub. We require to provide access to developers and other team members on project and repositories to complete our work. Either you can provide the access to individual users or you can control the access by grouping users in a team. If you are managing a large enterprise's environment, then it is a best recommendation to create teams and provide the access to users. At this moment, I have one organization called team training and I have one project in it called Java project. I don't have any team, but I have one repository linked in this project called Git Demo. So let's create a team in the project. Click on Team tab and create a new team. Give the name of team. I am going to create a new team called Full-Time Developer and I will create another team called Contractor Developer. All member in this team is full-time employee of my organization. Team visibility. I am selecting team visibility. It means that my team is going to be visible to everyone. Let's go ahead and create team. Team has been created, but I don't have any team member apart from the owner of this organization. Click on members and add a member. Now you require to send a invitation to users to add in this team. I have another account on GitHub for the demonstration. In the production environment, a user must be existed in the GitHub before inviting or adding in a team. You can invite the people by email address or name. It is always recommended to use a name because it is unique in GitHub. So I'm inviting the users in a team. This is the user to whom I want to invite or add in a team, but this user account is not member of my organization. So first, this user account has to be added into my organization. So let's go ahead and send a invitation to this user. Invite. Now you can see here one pending member. Now user has to be accepted my invitation. The invitation has sent on email of this user account. This is the invitation and you require to accept. Click on join team. Once you accepted the invitation, go back in your organization and go back in your team option and refresh it. Now you can see here two member has been added. One is organization owner and second one is team member of this organization. But we haven't assigned any project or repository. You can see project 0, repository 0. Let's assign a project to this team. So click on the organization and click on projects. Click on the Java project and click on menu, then click on settings, click on teams, click on add a team and search a team. Here we are providing a read-only access to this team on this project. You can see a information here. If the permission are set up on organization level, then permission are going to be inherit from the organization instead of team. Let's verify. Click on options and look at here, organization member permission. From the organization level, this user account have the write access, but on team permission level it has read access. But organization level permission override the team level permission. So let's change the permission from write to read. Select read and save it. Now let's verify the permissions. If you click on the home page of the other user, you will see a page like this and you will get the link of the team under the your team. So click on full-time developer team and it has a permission on one project. This user account has read-only access on this project. Let's try to edit the project board. We are not getting a option to edit project board or edit this project. Let's try to give the right permission to this team on this project. Go back to your organization GitHub account under the team. Change the permission from read to write and go back to the other user account. Refresh this page. Now the permission got changed from read to write. Click on the project. Now you will be able to edit the project board. Click on edit notes. Save the note. Yes, we successfully able to save the notes. Let's revert back the permission from write to read. So this is the permission on the project level, but this user account doesn't have the access on project repository. You can see here repository 0, but this team doesn't have any repository yet. Let's assign a repository to this team. So go back your organization account. So click on teams and then click on full-time developer. You can see here at this moment this team has a project but doesn't have any repository. So click on repositories, then click on add repository and search the repository in your organization repository to team. At this moment team has read access on this repository. Click on repository and let's try to edit this file to check the permissions. Look at here, you are trying to edit this file but you don't have the right access. So this user account has only read access on this repository. Let's try to give the right permission to this team on this repository. Go back your organization GitHub account and click on teams and click on teams. Select the team and click on repositories and change the permission from read to write. Now go back your other user GitHub account. Click on team. Click on repositories. Now this team have the right access on this repositories. Let's try to edit this file. Try to commit or save the changes. Great. Now this team or user account have the write access on this repository. By using this method, you can create multiple teams and you can assign the required privilege on project as well as repository on GitHub. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.